Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Machine Learning, Module 3, Unsupervised Learning. I am D. Shaktivel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Technology, KG College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. And we are going to discuss about what is K-means algorithm, how does the K-means algorithm work, how to choose the value of K number of clusters in K-means clustering algorithm. What is K-means algorithm? K-means clustering is an unsupervised learning algorithm which groups the unlabeled dataset into different clusters. Here, K defines the number of predefined clusters that need to be created in the process. As if K equal to 2, there will be a 2 clusters. And for K equal to 3, there will be a 3 cluster and so on. It is an iterative algorithm that divides the unlabeled data set into k different clusters in such a way that each data set belongs to only one group that has similar properties. It allows us to cluster the data into different groups, and a convenient way to discover the categories of groups in the unlabeled data sets on its own without the need for any training. It is a centroid based algorithm where each cluster is associated with a centroid. The main aim of this algorithm is to minimize the sum of distance between the data point and their corresponding clusters. The algorithm takes the unlabeled data set as input, divides the data set into k number of clusters, and repeats the process until it does not find the best clusters. The value of k should be predetermined in this algorithm. The K-means cluster algorithm mainly performs two tasks. First one, determines the best value for K center points or centroid by an iterative process, assigns each data point to its closest K center. Those data points which are near to particular K center create a cluster. Hence, each cluster has data points with some commonalities, and it is away from other clusters. The below diagram explains the working of K-means clustering algorithm before K-means and after K-means. How does the K-means algorithm work? The working of K-means algorithm is explained in the below steps. Number one, select the number K to decide the number of cluster. Step two, select random k points or centroid. It can be other from the input data set. Step 3. Assign each data point to their closest centroid, which will form the predefined k cluster. Step 4. Calculate the variances and place a new centroid of each cluster. Step 5. Repeat the third steps, which means reassign each data point to the new closest centroid of each cluster. Step 6. If any reassignment occurs, then go to step 4, else go to finish. Step 7. The model is ready. How does the K-means algorithm work? Let us understand the above steps by considering the visual point. Suppose we have two variables, M1 and M2. Then XY axis, this is a scatter plot of these two variables, is given below. Let's take number k of cluster, that is k equal to 2, to identify the data set and to put them into different cluster. It means here we will try to group these data set into two different clusters. We need to choose some random k points or centroid to form the cluster. These points can either the data, either the points from the data set or any other points. So we are selecting the below two points as k, two points as k points, which are not the part of our data set. Consider the below image. Now we will assign each data point of the cluster plot to its closest k point or center point. We will compute it by applying some mathematics that we have studied to calculate the distance between the two points. So we will draw a median between both the points, both the centroids. Consider the below image. From the above image, it is clear that points left side of the line is nearer to the K1 or a blue centroid, and the points to the right side of the line are close to the yellow centroid. Let's color them as blue and yellow for clear visualization. As we need to find the closest cluster, so we will repeat the process by choosing a new centroid. To choose the new centroid, we will compute the center of gravity of this centroid and we will find new centroid as below. Next, we will reassign each data point to the new centroid. For this, we will repeat the same process to finding a median line. The median line will be like below image. From the MO image, we can see one yellow point is on the left side of the line and two blue points are the right side of the line. So these three points will be assigned to a new cluster, new centroid. As reassignment has taken place, so we will again go to step 4, which is finding new centroid or K points. We will repeat the process by finding the center of gravity of centroid. So the new centroid will be as shown in the below. As we got new centroid, so again we'll draw the median line, reassign the data point, so the image will be. We can see in the above image there are no dissimilar data points on either side of the line, which means our model is formed. Consider the below image. How to choose the value of k number of cluster in k-means clustering? The performance of k-means clustering algorithm depends upon highly efficient clusters that it forms, but choosing the optimal number of clusters is a big task. There are some different ways to find the optimal number of clusters, but here we are discussing the most important appropriate method to find number of clusters or value of k. The method is given below. Elbow method. Elbow method is one of the most popular ways to find the optimal number of clusters. This method uses the concept of WCSS value. WCSS stands for within cluster sum of squares, which defines the total variations within a clusters. The formula to calculate the value of WCSS for three clusters is given below. WCSS equal to sum of pi in cluster 1, point in cluster 1, distance between a point and the centroid, whole power plus sum of pi in cluster 2, distance of pi c2 whole power plus sum of pi in the cluster 3, distance of pi c3 whole power 2. In the above, the formula of WCSS, sum pi in the cluster 1, distance into pi c1, the whole power 2. It is a sum of square of the distance between each point that is centroid within a cluster 1, and the same for other two terms. To measure the distance between data points and the centroid, we can use any method such as Euclidean distance or Manhattan distance. To find the optimal value of clusters, the elbow method follows the below steps. It executes the k-means clustering on a given data set for different k values range 1 to 10. For each value of k, calculates the WCSS value. Plots a curve between a calculated WCSS value and the number of clusters k. The short point of bend or a point of the plot looks like an arm, then that point is considered as the best value of k. Thank you for watching this video. We will see the next module.